And hello, wrestling fans. Welcome to this week's edition of Mid-South Wrestling Television. I'm your host, Boyd Pierce, and we have a lot of excitement coming up. We have with us as our guest commentator this week a man who needs no introduction throughout the Southwest, the popular sports director of KALB Channel 5 in Alexandria, Louisiana, Mr. Buddy Nichols. Buddy, we'll be talking to you in a little bit right now. We want to tell the fans at home a great card signed by matchmaker Grizzly Smith. It'll be headlined by a Mid-South tag team match. You'll see Mr. Olympia and his partner Boris Zirkov as they take on the popular duo of the Junkyard Dog and Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Another tag team will feature two bigger, rugged men, the Super Destroyer and his partner, King Kong Bundy. Popular Tito Santana's here, Magnum TA. We have a lot of action coming up, and Buddy Nichols, we'll be looking forward to your expert commentary, as you did when you was with us about three months previous. We've been enjoying it ever since then, looking forward to when you'd be back with us.
Well, thank you very much, Boyd. It's nice to be back again, always treated with the best of hospitality here at Mid-South.
Thank you. And we go now to the ring and the introduction of the opening event. Here's Reese Bowden.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 227 pounds from Los Angeles, California, Rip Rogers. And in the blue corner at 222 pounds from Knoxville, Tennessee, Tim Horner.
And the opening event being introduced. As you see, Tim Horner taking off his green and white jacket and his opponent across the ring, Rip Rogers in the purple trunks. The referee checking to see that everything's in order and calling for the bell, Joel Armstrong, and here's Buddy.
Okay, thank you very much, Boyd. Again, the lavender trunks, Rip Rogers out of Los Angeles, California, as Boyd mentioned, and the feisty Tim Horner out of Knoxville, Tennessee, in the green wrestling tights, green wrestling shoes, and also the green knee pads. Tim Horner, one of the finest youngsters in the Mid-South right now, can handle just about any type of competition. I've had the opportunity, Boyd, to see him wrestle against King Kong Bundy down in Alexandria. Held his own with that big man, and when you do that, you've done a day's work.
Exactly.
Right now, Horner with the hammerlock, and Rip Rogers very conveniently moves over to the ropes, and the referee Armstrong breaks him up. Horner with a side headlock now. Horner, a very talented young man out of the University of Tennessee, wrestled collegiately at the University of Tennessee for a couple of years, decided to take that profession up as a professional wrestler and has done quite well for himself, just waiting for that big opportunity, waiting for that big win, and it could come at any moment, as Tim Horner has all the tools to take care of himself inside the squared circle. Rogers throws Horner up against the ropes, but Rogers comes off strong with a shoulder. Now Horner with a body slam, and Rogers feeling it in his back. Nice drop kick by Horner, and right now he has Rip Rogers reeling a little bit. Takes him down hard. Now Rogers trying to worm his way out of it, trying to get a head scissor on Horner, but Horner locking tight on the headlock, side headlock. Hangs on as Rip Rogers picks him up, and Rogers feels the discomfort of the mat as Horner held on. Again, Rogers that time got the head scissors, but Horner quick enough to kick out as he does once again. And again, Tim Horner goes right for the side headlock and takes him down. Nice hip toss by Tim Horner. This is a one fall, 10-minute time limit. Two evenly matched wrestlers going after it here in the first two or three minutes of this 10-minute time limit. A lot of action now as they both carry them off the ropes. Horner goes down, and again, arm drag and takedown, and Rogers again goes to the small of the back, a lot of pain on his face, and Horner goes right back again with that tight side headlock, really putting a lot of pressure on Rip Rogers. Rogers out of Los Angeles, California, has been in the Mid-South area for the past two or three months. Horner takes an elbow. Ooh, boy, that was right to the chin and to the upper part of the chest. And he took a lot of punishment on that one lick. Now Rogers beginning to take control of the match, but Horner tries to come back with a right to the midsection. And Rogers puts him hard into the turnbuckle. Again, Rip Rogers trying to take control of this match, which has been in control mostly by Horner, as Horner kicks out. Referee Armstrong not even able to get a one count. Rogers with the body slam, goes for the lateral press, but again, Horner quickly kicks out and counters with a right, but Rogers gets him off the ropes. A high backflip, oh, he has him on the counter, and Rogers quickly gets out of it and then takes a right to the chops. Horner again, this time with a forearm up to the right side of the face. Horner again with the elbow, trying to put Rip Rogers away here in this one fall, 10-minute time limit match, opening match of the program. A reversal. Horner flying body press. He gets him one, two, three, and he got him. Tim Horner, a big winner, boy.
And we'll be back with more action after this message from Mid-South Wrestling.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 260 pounds from Rome, Georgia, Tony Zane. And in the blue corner at 237 pounds from Virginia Beach, Virginia, Magnum T.A.
Two fine young wrestlers from the southern part of the United States. Magnum T.A. Terry Allen versus the larger opponent in the form of Tony Zane. Johnny Martinez, the referee. Ready?
Okay, Boyd, my first opportunity to see Magnum T.A.
Magnum T.A. came upon the scene 2 weeks ago and captivated the fans here in the area and put the great fear into his opponent, so we'll see how he does on his third appearance here on Mid-South Wrestling.
Well, in talking to other people that keep up with professional wrestling, they say he is one of the bright and shining stars in professional wrestling and can look forward to a lot of good years from Magnum T.A.
Well, he came here to this area on the recommendation of the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, who put in some good words to matchmaker Grizzly Smith, and Grizzly took him up on it. He came, and no one was disappointed, and we're looking for great things from him. And Tony Zale, of course, would like to slow down the express that he started some 2 weeks ago.
Well, with a reference like Dusty Rhodes, how can you go wrong, Boyd? Okay, Magnum T.A., Terry Allen, fine, fine physical specimen, tries the arm dragon takedown. And Zane tried to hold off, but Magnum had enough force on it to get him down. Magnum T.A., Terry Allen, calls Virginia his home. Fine collegiate wrestler out of Old Dominion University. And has the good solid background, has all the skills, as we talked about earlier. Dusty Rhodes recommended him and has seen him wrestle. So what better recommendation could you have than the American Dream right now? He has the arm barred on Tony Zane out of Rome, Georgia. Zane in the purple trunks and the gold wrestling boots. And Magnum T.A. really putting a lot of pressure on that left arm of Tony Zane. Zane, another youngster that has been in the Mid-South area for the last few months. Again, looking for the opportunity to win the big match and catapult him into some of the larger matches. He backs Magnum T.A. up against the ropes. Again, T.A. comes off with the big shoulder and puts Zane down. Zane tries the flip. It doesn't work. Magnum T.A. tries the drop kick and just barely got him. Wasn't a very powerful one, but he got just enough of him to knock him off his feet. And again, he goes back to that left arm, putting the pressure on the left arm of Tony Zane. As Boyd mentioned earlier, Tony Zane out of Rome, Georgia. Nice flip by Magnum T.A. The count quickly by the referee. However, Zane still not out of it enough to where that would be a pinning combination. Zane, again, taking a lot of pressure on that left arm and left shoulder area. As Magnum T.A. continues to work on the left side of Tony Zane.
Our next event, we'll see Tito Santana, the popular star, versus Mike Vachon, making his debut here in Mid-South. Then tag team action, Super Destroyer and King Kong Bundy. There!
Big body slam by Magnum T.A. again. He takes him down.
Super Destroyer and King Kong Bundy against Denny Alberts and newcomer Craig Carson. And then we'll have the Mid-South Tag Team match. Mr. Olympia and Boris Zirkov against the Junkyard Dog and Hacksaw Jim Dugan. So lots of great action this week. We invite you to stay with us all the way.
Looking forward to that tag team combination of Bundy and the Super Destroyer. The flying body press again. Zane able to physically get out of it. He kept his momentum going and was able to roll out of it. But Magnum TA comes right back. Three hard rights, a couple to the chin area and one to the midsection. Now the reversal by Zane. Zane comes in hard, and Magnum TA gets out of the way just in time, but cannot put the clincher on him, as Tony Zane is really staying tough here with Magnum TA. There's the big high body flip, and Magnum TA getting some response from the crowd. There's that atomic knee drop. And again, two, three, and that's it. Magnum.
Magnum TA gains a victory, and we'll be back. Tito Santana versus Mike Bashaun after this important word.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 232 pounds from Montreal, Canada, Mike Bashaun. And in the blue corner at 238 pounds from Mission, Texas, Tito Santana.
And listen to the accolades given to the popular star from the South Texas portion, the city of Mission, Tito Santana, as he takes on a newcomer to Mid-South wrestling, but not to the wrestling profession, and Mike Bashaun, who is a second-generation grappler, his father being the famous Maurice Mad Dog Bashaun.
The Bashaun name, as you said, Boyd, really goes back a long time, a lot of experience in his father, and if any of that has floated down, then he's in pretty good shape. Tito Santana, however, experienced himself as the, I guess you could call him a young veteran. He is talented, has been around a few years and has really developed a lot of excellent wrestling skills and has wrestled a lot of the big names around the country. Tito Santana, as we said, out of the great state of Texas, as he pushes Bashaun over into the far ropes. Bashaun really gets upset looking. And Tito Santana, nice reversal on the hammerlock. And again, Bashaun retreats to the safety of the ropes on the near side. Tito Santana. Tito, a very talented college athlete, did a little collegiate wrestling out at West Texas State. West Texas had a pretty good run on some professional wrestlers, Boyd.
They certainly did, and now they're making a good run into professional wrestling. Now, as they left college football, they spread out to the different areas, and they have been heard from everywhere.
Tito Santana again with the side headlock on Mike Bashaun out of Montreal, Canada. Again, Bashaun taken down off the ropes by Tito Santana. Santana takes him high with a powerful body slam, and Bashaun tries to get to the ropes, but Santana quickly gets him up, and the hip lock takedown. Bashaun rolls Santana over. Might have had some assistance with the wrestling trunks, couldn't see from our advantage.
You know, Buddy, now in Montreal, Quebec, Canada, where Mike Bashaun is from, you know, the wrestling programs there are printed one half in English and one half in French. The same words, the same wording and everything, but that's the way it is because it is a French-Canadian city.
It is a very bilingual city. And they too, we talk about West Texas State producing some pretty good wrestlers. The Canadian province has also produced a lot of good professional wrestlers that have migrated down into the United States and have made their names in wrestling annals. Again, Tito Santana in control right now with the side headlock on Mike Bashaun. He throws Santana. Santana comes over the top. The high drop kick, and Bashaun goes down quickly. Tito Santana quickly goes right back to the side headlock and takes him down back to the mat as Bashaun has his back on the mat once again. This is a one fall, 10-minute time limit. Tito Santana in the black wrestling tights and Bashaun in the black Olympic type wrestling tights with the red and green shoes. Also have a good crowd on hand today here at
tremendous crowd
at the O'Neill Boys Club in Shreveport. They have just been coming in constantly for the last few minutes, knowing where they can find some action. Tito Santana again on the attack. Ooh, a roundhouse shot to the face of Bashan. He puts Bashan back down again. And right now, Tito Santana in full control of this match, looking for a victory. But Bashan is going to be no easy prey. Again, goes for the toe lock in the reverse. He bridges him over backwards. Two, and that is it. Oh, didn't quite get him. Yes, he did.
And Joel Armstrong counts him out, calls for the bell, and the victor, Tito Santana, over Mike Bashan. We'll have tag team action coming up, and we'll view it along with you right after this word from Mid-South Wrestling.
It's tag team action now for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 420 pounds from Atlantic City, New Jersey, King Kong Bundy. And his big partner at 287 pounds from Atlanta, Georgia, Super Destroyer. In the blue corner at 230 pounds from Lakewood, Ohio, Denny Alberts. And his partner at 232 pounds from Round Rock, Texas, Craig Carson.
Tag team action now as Denny Alberts and Craig Carson being introduced in the far corner across the way. Buddy Nichols, how big is big and how tough is tough? Awesome team nonetheless in the form of the Super Destroyer who's in the ring now and his partner on the outside, King Kong Bundy.
A very unenviable position as far as Denny Alberts and Craig Carson are concerned. As you mentioned, Boyd, the big and tough team of the Super Destroyer and King Kong Bundy from Atlantic City. And right now, Super Destroyer goes to work on Denny Alberts. Takes that big foot coming off the ropes, and boy, that will really stun you in a moment as he tags out and throws him right into Bundy. And Bundy never even flinched. The one-handed body slam by Bundy. And Denny Alberts right now looks for some help over the corner, but he can't get with Craig Carson. As again, we see the teamwork of Bundy and the Super Destroyer as they keep Denny Alberts in their corner and working him over quite extensively. Super Destroyer with the big elbow. And it just happened to be in the corner where Alberts could tag out to Carson. And before Carson can even get in the ring good, Super Destroyer has him into the turnbuckles quickly. Carson now trying to fight back. A little mule kick does no damage to the Destroyer as he tags out to King Kong Bundy. And again, the double teaming action, and Carson really slammed into Bundy. The 400 plus pound body of King Kong Bundy again, not even flinching. And Carson takes a big elbow off the rope and goes down. Bundy with that big, big telephone pole of an arm, forearm to the back, and now a shot to the forehead. And now they have Craig Carson reeling a little bit. Again, Carson in trouble, tries to go to his corner and get a little bit of relief from Denny Alberts, but to no avail, as Bundy whips him in and takes the big left knee right into Carson. And that has to take the breath out of you. Again, the tag and the Super Destroyer outside the ring now with a big forearm right across the upper part of the chest. And again, Carson tries to fight back, has the big knee lift, and has the Super Destroyer stunned momentarily enough for him to get to the corner to tag out to Denny Albert. Albert, however, comes right in and meets a right hand of the Super Destroyer. The flying dropkick off the ropes, and Albert quickly to the canvas. And King Kong Bundy will be back in. Again, the same tactic, just throwing him right into Bundy's body. Bundy sacrificing his body, but I don't think he's doing much sacrificing as big as he is. Again, the big bear hug, and he has Denny Albert in a lot of pain. A lot of pain as referee Johnny Martinez checks with him, and Bundy just throws him down on the canvas. Tags out, Super Destroyer now back in. a right hand to the face. Alberts tries to come back but cannot. Again, another right hand to the midsection, but it has very little effect on the Super Destroyer. A combination. And he whips the Big D in, and he comes off with a shot off that right foot, and Denny Alberts is back in trouble again. There it is. Takes him up to the top rope on the far side. And boy, this is something that not many men can make it through, as the big suplex off the top rope. Now, wait a minute. Super Destroyer says, Bundy, you come in. So they tag out. And Denny Alberts is in a lot of pain. He is really almost to the point of being unconscious, Boyd.
He doesn't know whether Bundy has him or the Super Destroyer. There's no doubt about it.
Now, Bundy takes him up. Fire a carry over to the right side, and he lets him tag out. Boyd, I think right now this team of Bundy and Super Destroyer just trying to inflict some punishment on these.
Awesome. Raw power, buddy.
Just almost an unbeatable combination. There's that Atlantic City Avalanche. Three. Oop. Two more. The man with the five count, King Kong Bundy and
Bundy
Super Destroyer.
Super Destroyer in. It would have been a three count with Bundy in. He goes for the five count for a victory, and that's just what he gains for his team, and we'll be back after this word.
If you'll recall, last week here on Mid-South Wrestling, Hacksaw Butch Reed was scheduled for a bout with Tony Zane, but for some unknown reason, Hacksaw Butch Reed did not show up for that match, and I think at this time he'd like to offer an apology and an explanation as to what was wrong there.
Well, let me tell you something, Risa. You know, since I've been around in the Mid-South Wrestling area, like I said before, it's a very tough area. It's one of the toughest areas in the world, you understand? But I've been having a lot of things on my mind. I've had a lot of things to think about. And one of the things I've been thinking about is coming up here to wrestle Tony Zane. Man, dudes like Tony Zane, where I come from, don't even talk loud. I whoop that chump any day of the week, two times on Sunday. But let me tell you something. The big thing is that Butch Reed has been used. I feel like this, I've been used as a stepping stone around here in Mid-South Wrestling. I've been used for a fool, you understand? And I ain't nobody's fool. I've been having a lot of time to think about it. And one of the people that's been using me for a fool is a friend of mine, a good friend of mine, supposed to be. I've been riding up and down the road with. We broke bread together. Yeah, I'm talking about the junkyard dog. That's right. Let me tell you something. They tell me that in order for you to be on top at Mid-South Wrestling is you got to take on the biggest and the baddest competition there is. So that's what Butch Reed has been doing. I have been taking a lot of slack off of my brother, the Junkyard Dog. I've took on Ted DiBiase. I've took on Mr. Olympia. I've took on the Ugandan Giant Kambala. I have took on King Kong Bundy. People didn't think he'd leave his feet. They all seen him leave his feet. But see, the thing is this, Risa, is that I'm thinking about Butch Reed from now on. You understand? I'm softening all these dudes up, dog, for you to see where they're coming from and for you to take them on as a North American champion. He's a North American champion. The people last week wanted Duggan to be his partner. It come my time to shine in Mid-South professional wrestling. And because the people wanted Jim Duggan to be his partner, then he took Jim Duggan over me. Because that's what the people wanted him to do. Dog, I want to say this. that I am going to the top. And I know how I gotta go to the top. And that's by winning the North American Championship. You understand? Do you understand what I'm saying, Reese? Well,
that's a pretty big order, and I'm sure that a lot of the fans are just as surprised as I am to hear you talking like that about the dog.
Well, it's like this. They got their tag team champions. They got their tag team. But Butch Reed is going to start taking care of Butch Reed, you understand? And I can't take care of Butch Reed by listening to everybody else, listening to their suggestions. I know what I got to do to go to the top. The Junkyard Dog is a good, is a man, he's a bad wrestler. I got to give him that. He got the North American title. He's the champion. He is a big drawing card all over the country, all around the world. And so in order for you to be one of the best, you got to be up there with the best. And Dog, I want you to know I'm issuing a challenge to you in front of your people out here. That's right, they got it back here. I'm issuing a challenge to you, Dog, to come down here and sign a contract to take me on for that North American title. I'm tired of playing around. It's time for Butch Reed to be Butch Reed. It's time for Butch Reed to show the wrestling world that I am competitive and I am a man to be recognized. Now I'm waiting on the Dog to come down here and to sign a contract for the North American Championship.
Well, as I said, that comes as quite a surprise to me. I'm sure it probably is just as big a surprise to the Junkyard Dog. And
let me tell you something, Reese. Friendship ain't putting no food on my table. Friendship is not helping me to be a big name in professional wrestling. I don't have no friends. I don't need the Dog. I don't need nobody. All I need is me. And I'm gonna start taking care of me.
Well, all I can say about that is that I've known the Junkyard Dog about as long as he's been in professional wrestling, and I've never known him yet to walk away from a challenge. So
I've been knowing him a long time myself. He's the one that got me over here. The man has helped me out. There's no doubt about that. He's helped me out of a lot of things. He got me over here at Mid-South Wrestling. He got me set up here. I appreciate that. But now it's time for Butch Reed to go to the top. And the only way I'm going to go to the top is I got to win the North American Championship. And I'm waiting on the Dog to come down here and show that he is the Dog and sign a contract to wrestle me for the North American Championship.
Well, I don't think you'll have to wait too long because I see the Junkyard Dog coming right now. And as I pointed out a moment ago, I've never known the Junkyard Dog to walk away from a challenge. I don't think that we'll see that now either. And I think from the look on his face, he's pretty startled about this whole thing himself.
What is wrong with you? I sent for you in Atlanta. You didn't have water. I watered the crowd with. I set your apartment up. I bought your furniture. I got you in here. And now you're out here. Let me explain something to you. That's why our people.
That's my problem now. I've been listening to you too long, man.
That's why our people right now can't get to the top because crabs just like you is.
Thank you.
Wrestling fans, you saw it and heard it just like I did. I don't understand any of it. We try to get her composure, and I'm going to try to find out. We'll be back right after this message.
Well, boy, Pierce, it's pandemonium here. Everybody's standing. We've had to bring everything to a standstill. The Grizzly Smith has grabbed me to come down here and sit in for Buddy Nichols because that tag championship match is out. And, of course, I think everybody's shocked and enraged about Hacksaw Butch Reed. He sure caught everybody flat-footed. I don't know what's working on his head. I suspect Ted DiBiase as close by as he was. Let's go to Houston, Texas, May the 13th. Paul Bosch narrating as Ted DiBiase, before he broke his hand, was against a former All-American from Grambling and a former member of the Pittsburgh Steelers as a split receiver, Charlie Cook. Let's watch that bout. The final closing 3 minutes.
Cook drives in and, whoa, he clotheslined him. He did that. And DiBiase gets up there pleased with himself, pointing to that forehead of his, as much as to say, I made a smart move, and the people don't entirely agree with him. And he's trying to get the pile driver. Charlie Cook worked first. He made the first move and tossed him over. Now Cook, with those long arms of his, and he's finding tender territory, and the crowd is enthusiastic about urging him to move in there. Charlie Cook on the loose, trying to set him up. And Cook comes in there beautifully. He upended him that time. And he's popping away at Ted DiBiase's head, trying to shake him up. Now, he racks the corner, and bad move by Charlie. He tried to stop his rush in there and got his feet tangled up and fell into the top turnbuckle. And now it's DiBiase who is trying to make him pay for the mistake. Well-placed foot by Charlie Cook. He stopped him from using that spinning toehold. 15 minutes have gone by as Charlie Cook gets bounced against the turnbuckle. Been a solid pace in this match, a hard-fought pace. And as DiBiase sets Cook up, he goes for the crotch hold and the turn and the drive and the drop. Now they're... Oh, he caught him. He drove it in his throat. I was wondering what had happened. I saw that same thing happen, and I knew that... I knew that DiBiase had gotten away with it several times before, and I suddenly heard the bell, and it was the referee had called Now, as Ted DiBiase moves in and starts to knock his block off, here comes Charlie Cook, and here go I moving out of the way, and Charlie Cook is all over the floor in front of us here as DiBiase picks up a chair and starts to move in on him. And we've got the referee out here, and DiBiase is figuring to earn a disqualification, even if he doesn't think he earned one that time.
One of the few times that he was caught from blatantly continuing to use a thumb to the throat, Jerry Escher had the courage to disqualify him. But then you saw the venom of Ted DiBiase, and we saw it again here today. And he again is at the bottom of this stirring cauldron. And Boyd, we'll be back after these messages from Mid-South Network with our standby match.
This is a non-title tag team.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan has taken Johnny Rich, and all Reese Bowden got out with the non-title tag match. TV time remaining, and Hacksaw Duggan is after Skandar Akbar, but of course, that's left Johnny Rich at the mercy of Mr. Olympia and Boris Zhirkov, the Russian, who has by power of attorney taken Ted DiBiase's place and representing DiBiase while he has the broken hand in the Mid-South Tag Team title bout. And of course, a lot of things have happened. The crowd is still standing from the situation with Junkyard Dog and Butch Reed. And Butch Reed saying he's going to be his own man, that he's been used by the Dog. and that he's been softening up people for the dog, and then the dog dumped him when it was his chance to shine, to make the big money, to be the dog's partner when dog took Dugan as his partner. But you recall the people here on Mid-South selected Hacksaw Dugan. The junkyard dog had nothing to do with it. But Reed is really, he's really boiled it. Johnny Rich, a gallant youngster, a man that shown a lot of courage. He's fought some of the tough ones here. Boris Zirkov in on him. And Skandar Akbar, Hacksaw Dugan ran him clear out of the arena floor here. Wow, Johnny Rich really took that melon-headed Boris Zirkov and taught him some respect. And there comes Hacksaw. And he's in there firing away on both of them. Oh, he just threw Boris Zirkov at Mr. Olympia. Body slammed Zirkov, body slammed Olympia. This war may not get over with the television time remaining, Boyd Pierce, but it's been a pandemonium day here. Hacksaw Dugan is at, oh, Olympia loading
over
that boot.
Corner,
Olympia's loading that boot. Johnny Rich sacrificed himself. Johnny Rich sacrificed himself and took that, whatever that foreign object was on that boot that Olympia had for Hacksaw Dugan from behind. Johnny Rich showed his courage, took it to his head, but now both feet are on Dugan, and Johnny Rich is stunned outside the ring on the concrete floor. Double clothesline, Zirkov with his powerful neck breaker that has devastated so many. And Olympia keeping Johnny Rich out of the way. Oh, Dugan got out of the way. Hacksaw Dugan, he's not down until you nail the lid shut on him. He's a fighter. Now Olympia calling for help, and they're both on him, two on one. They went for the clothesline. Dugan clotheslined both of them. Hacksaw Jim Dugan clotheslined them both. And now he's showing them some shoe leather. Olympia staggered up. Dugan's got them both. Boyd Pierce, Johnny Rich sacrifice. But Jim Dugan may pull the impossible. He may whip both of them. 2 minutes of airtime remaining. Oh, Dugan got out of the way. That's 6 cents. The spear. He speared Zirkov. Zirkov out on the floor. Mr. Olympia up, and Dugan's got him, body slam. And Johnny Rich is groggy, doesn't know where he is. Dugan checking on him. And Dugan speared Mr. Olympia. He's tagged Johnny Rich. What a heart. Hacksaw Dugan's tagged Rich and just thrown Rich across. He just threw Rich across Mr. Olympia. He gave Rich the victory. He gave Rich the victory. Johnny Rich still doesn't know where he is. That's the kind of heart Dugan has. When Johnny Rich sacrificed for him, Dugan paid him back by giving that youngster the biggest victory of his whole career here on Mid-South. Hey, look at that crowd. Look at that crowd, Boyd.
The fans are going crazy, Bill.
Oh, I'm telling you, it's been pandemonium here. And, of course, we still don't know the complete story, but Hacksaw Butch Reed has shocked the wrestling world. And I tell you, a man that's probably more shocked and disappointed than hurt, even though he's hurt in agony right now, is the Junkyard Dog. And of course, Ted DiBiase somewhere, and money, smell of Skandar Akbar, has to be involved. Yeah. Next week, we got a big main event, boy.
Next
tell them about it.
Tito Santana versus the big man from Atlantic City, King Kong Bundy. So it promises to spill over, Bill, and continue to be the wildest action anywhere in professional wrestling. We saw something today. We keep saying we never seen it before, but somehow it unfurls right here because all the top stars. So till next week, for our guest commentator, Buddy Nichols, who was with us earlier, Cowboy Bill Watts, I'm Boyd Pierce saying thanks for tuning us in, and we'll see you next week right here on this great station.
Hello, wrestling fans. Welcome to this week's Mid-South Wrestling Television Network. I'm your host, Boyd Pierce, and we'll be headlining this week an outstanding main event. Tito Santana, the popular star from South Texas, takes on 420-pound King Kong Bundy. The Mid-South Tag Team Champions, Boris Zirkov and Mr. Olympia are here. Also, Mr. Wrestling 2, Tim Horner, Magnum TA. You'll see all the action, and I wanted to tell you about it. A man who needs no introduction, he's second to none in breaking down the fine points of professional wrestling. That's Cowboy Bill Watts. Bill.
Well, thank you, Boyd Pierce. And I just say this, it's been tremendous excitement lately. And, of course, some things that have happened, some unbelievable things, some things that have left me flabbergasted, and I know you too, and the fans at home. And last week, a man that was hurt to the core, not only physically, but I think mentally, the Junkyard Dog. And we'll see some of that and go into that a little bit further as it progresses. But let's go to Reese Bowden right now and get the action off with a man that's a legend in his own time, Mr. Wrestling 2.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 232 pounds from Lakewood, Ohio, Denny Albert. And in the blue corner at 236 pounds from Atlanta, Georgia, Mr. Wrestling 2.
Opening event, Denny Albert's taking on the popular legend, Mr. Wrestling number 2, as Joel Armstrong calls for the bell, and here's Bill.
This should be a good match. Wrestling 2 is certainly always an aggressor. He doesn't wait on anybody. He doesn't pace himself. He doesn't wait on the other man and then counter him. He's on the attack. He's one of those individuals that can be attacking and still just be effective with his movement and his skills. Look at him. He just manhandles Denny Albert's right up. Joel Armstrong on top of the action there. Good-looking young referee. It's good to see Grizzly Smith get some new faces in the refereeing division also. I'm sure the fans appreciate it. Denny Albert says, well, let me out of here. I got to regroup. Wrestling 2 was going for a front face lock, and everybody knows that he's bulldog tenacious with that front face lock. Coming up next, we will have Tito Santana, one of the finest young athletes I've ever been fortunate enough to witness, against the awesome man from Atlantic City, King Kong Bundy. Wrestling 2 armbar. Denny Albert's armbar back in. 2, drop toe hold. And right up on him, 2, quick as a cat. The man has tremendous technique, tremendous competitor. In demand all over the world. Headquartered out of Atlanta, Georgia for a tremendously successful amount of time. A living legend. Oh, Denny Albert was wise to back off quick, Boyd. If you pause too quick on that break, you catch that knee lift. You could hear the impact of that body check right there, clear over here. And 2 was going for the coup de grace. And Denny Albert knew it and got out of the way. Side headlock, take over. Two has pulled Denny Albert's clear through. Denny's into the ropes. Joel Armstrong calling for the break. Clears through. That's the way a referee should do it. Should clear through till the man that was on the bottom in the ropes has time to regain his feet. They should both start from a neutral position. Oh, well, Denny Albert's after 2 and Joel Armstrong rightfully backing him off. Denny Albert's didn't give the same courtesy to Wrestling 2. Well, I'll tell you, he's dealing with somebody that knows how to handle those things. Another packed house here at the Irish McNeil Boys Club. Uh-oh, Wrestling 2 firing away, Boyd.
Well, he's the aggressor. There's no doubt about Wrestling 2. Like I say, you look for that knee and he'll use both hands on you, so there's no way he really has a great aggressiveness now in this match. You think a lot of people say he's slowed down, but I'm sure Denny Albert would be the last one in the world to agree with you right now.
Well, like I said, he's like fine wine. He gets better. He's like George Blanda was in football, Kenny Stabler. They got that tremendous experience. They got that competitive desire that got him there. You know, when Blanda even was in the twilight of his years, he had that tremendous competitive desire. And look at Wrestling 2 right there. And I'll tell you, Denny Albert was just about decapitated. He doesn't really know what day it is. And now he may not know what week it is as Wrestling 2 puts a coup de grace in the knee lift ring.
That finished him up. As that knee hit him, he became an astrologer looking at the stars. Joel Armstrong raises his hand in victory. We'll be back. King Kong Bundy versus Tito Santana after this message.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 420 pounds from Atlantic City, New Jersey, from Devastation Incorporated, King Kong Bundy. And in the blue corner at 238 pounds, from Mission, Texas, Tito Santana.
And you hear the accolade from the fans, the introduction of the popular star from South Texas, Tito Santana, against 420 pounds from Atlantic City, New Jersey, King Kong Bundy.
My boy, the whole crowd has been buzzing in anticipation of this main event. And this is what makes Mid-South Sports the greatest television wrestling in the world today, is that matches like these, main events, look at that power. And Tito Santana knows he's outweighed and he can't stand in power for power. He's going to have to use his skill and his movement. But Tito was a great football player at West Texas State University. He's been a super wrestling star for the past 5 to 7 years. And he's had experience against big men, and he knows the tactics he has to use. He has to somehow wear Bundy down and keep away from head-on conflicts where the size and the weight can just overpower him until he gets the opportunity to get Bundy's weight working against him and then get into that leg hold of his, because Tito's leg hold, I don't care who you are, you can't go without your wheels. And if Bundy gets those big, massive tree trunks that he's got for legs taken out from under him, he can't support all that weight on one leg, and then Tito can get him vulnerable, and you only have to pin Bundy for a three count. Bundy's contract states that he has to pin you for a five count, or it doesn't count as a victory for Bundy. Oh, and Tito's got Bundy upset. He's got him upset, maybe a little of a matador in Tito Santana. Listen to this crowd, they love it, seeing Bundy upset. Maybe Tito's psychology is to get Bundy so insanely mad that he'll rush him and get overconfident. Look at Tito, he's quick. He's not sitting in any one spot in the ring. He's moving, he's keeping that lateral movement. Now he's stepping in to a side headlock. I don't expect him to hold it too long. Just about the time Bundy thinks he knows what Tito's gonna do, I'm sure Tito will use something to change his attack. A powerful young man, Tito Santana. He's binding, he's grinding. He's working on that headlock. He's got some pressure on it. And he's trying to twist Bundy's melon head right off. Bundy forced him into the ropes. This could be dangerous. Referee calling for the break. Oh, Tito made a critical mistake. Meeting him head on from Tito's years in football. You ought to know with that much mass difference, you're gonna lose that battle. Tito lost it again. Another young referee out there, Johnny Martinez. Oh, Tito stunned him. Oh, good drop kick. Did you see the tremendous extension? As Tito was in midair, how he's fired those legs through. But still, Bundy is so big and so much mass, he could only back him up. He couldn't take him off his feet. Tito was hoping to surprise him and take him clear off his feet. And then with his cat-like reflexes, capitalize.
Now the fans are getting on his case, Bill.
Well, they're certainly pulling all 100% for Tito Santana. Oh, Tito going for a body slam. I'm telling you, that's a hard road there. Bundy powering in. You're not going to slam him just walking up and getting him. I think you're going to have him in motion. He's going to have to be on the run for you to elevate him with a body slam. Tito going in for a single leg. Bundy stopped him and dropped that elbow on him. You got to move his mass off his base when you single leg him. You got to get that leg out from under him and moved. You can't let him set that weight on top of it. You got to make Bundy wrestle your match. You can't wrestle his match, that pounding. Of course, one thing Tito's smart at, if he had the time to make Bundy go a long endurance-type match, I'm sure his size and weight would work against him in endurance. But here on television, where the falls are one fall or a 10-minute time limit, Tito has to be coming into Bundy in order to get a decision, and that may give it a big edge in Bundy's favor.
Oh, Bundy, roundhouse. Oh, Tito stung him. Tito stung him. He popped him again, Boyd. And those are right on the button. He's hammering him. But Bundy comes back with that massive ham. You know, Bundy's punches don't have the snap of Tito's, but they got the tremendous mass and power behind him, and they have a tremendous shock. Johnny Martinez counting for the break, trying to get in between them, but it's almost impossible. Oh, man, he turned Tito almost a complete flip, Boyd.
Well, Bill, his match has turned around in the last few seconds. The aggressor, King Kong Bundy, using all 420 pounds and driving it to Tito Santana.
I'll tell you, Bundy is awesome. He is an awesome individual. He's another one that JURD and Hacksaw Dugan have to deal with. And Mr. Wrestling, too. And Tito Santana having to deal with him right now. And Bundy shows that he can. Oh, he did, gave Tito a backbreaker. Going for that big splash. Oh, Tito got out. Tito got out, or else he'd have been a grease spot, Boyd.
If he hadn't gotten up then, I don't believe he could have gotten
and it
up.
It stunned Bundy. Bundy had thought he had him, and Tito, there's that quickness. He's quick to capitalize on Bundy's mistake. Tito is stunned as it is, but he's got a great heart, and he's taking it to Bundy. And he has really got, he's going for the fall. Oh, Bundy powered him out. Tito's kicking that leg, trying to get that leg out from under him. He's stinging Bundy. Bundy can't get set. Tito got him. Tito got him. He's going for his hole, Boyd. He's twisting on it. He's twisting on that knee, Boyd. He's got Bundy on his back, and if he could get that hole locked up, he'll take Bundy home and beat him right here on TV. Oh, Bundy stunned him. Bundy stunned him. Well, Tito, tremendous extension on his drop kick, but that Bundy stands right into it. Tito's budging him now. He's backing him up. He knocked Bundy. He leveled him. Now Tito's going to put him away. Oh, Bundy ducked. Bundy ducked, and Tito was right into those steel cables. Oh, Bundy over the top rope. Bundy over the top rope. This is the new Bundy. When he gets in trouble, he seems not to care about winning. He wants to injure somebody. And he took Tito right over that top rope. And now he's handing it. Martinez is called for the disqualification. But Bundy's going for that pile driver. And he just piled Tito Santana on the floor. He just pile drive Tito Santana on the floor. Boyd Pierce, Tito Santana is out. He is. And look at Bundy.
Out of it, but he gains a victory on the disqualification of King Kong Bundy for over the top rope. We'll be back after this important message from Mid-South Wrestling.
Well, last week, ladies and gentlemen, Racer Bowden had scheduled an appearance with Hacksaw Butch Reed for an apology to the fans at home for his failure to appear the week before in a bout against Tony Zane. But an apology indeed. We got a monologue of a deranged mind that appeared at, he had figured everything out and everything pointed back to Junkyard Dog causing him to get beat by Bundy and the miss and everything else. And all anybody's ever been able to ascertain is that the dog is the guy that helped him the most. And yet Bundy and his, Hacksaw Reed in his twisted state has blamed Dog for everything. And let's watch the final moments before that confrontation now.
The Junkyard Dog is a good, is a man, he's a bad wrestler. I got to give him that. He got the North American title. He's the champion. He is a big drawing card all over the country, all around the world. And so in order for you to be one of the best, you got to be up there with the best. And Dog, I want you to know, I'm issuing a challenge to you. In front of your people out here, that's right, let's get him back here. I mentioned a challenge to you, Dog, to come down here and sign a contract to take me on for that North American title. I'm tired of playing around. It's time for Butch Reed to be Butch Reed. It's time for Butch Reed
to show the rest of the world that I am competitive and I am a man to be recognized. Now I'm waiting on the dog to come down here and to sign a contract for the North American Championship.
Well, as I said, that comes as quite a surprise to me. I'm sure it probably is just as big a surprise to the Junkyard Dog. And
let me tell you something, Reason. Friendship ain't putting no food on my table. Friendship is not helping me to be a big name in professional wrestling. I don't have no friends. I don't need the dog. I don't need nobody. All I need is me. And I'm gonna start taking care of me.
Well, all I can say about that is that I've known the Junkyard Dog about as long as he's been in professional wrestling, and I've never known him yet to walk away from a challenge, so.
I've been knowing him a long time myself. He's the one that got me over here. The man has helped me out. There's no doubt about that. He's helped me out of a lot of things. He got me over here at Mid-South Wrestling. He got me set up here. I appreciate that. But now it's time for Butch Reed to go to the top. And the only way I'm gonna go to the top is I got to win the North American Championship. And I'm waiting on the dog to come down here and show that he is the dog and sign a contract to wrestle me for the North American Championship.
Well, I don't think you'll have to wait too long because I see the Junkyard Dog coming right now. And as I pointed out a moment ago, I've never known the Junkyard Dog to walk away from a challenge. I don't think that we'll see that now either. And I think from the look on his face, he's pretty startled about this whole thing himself.
What is wrong with you? I sent for you in Atlanta. You didn't have water I wanted to cry with. I set your apartment up. I bought your furniture. I got you in here. And now you're out here. Let me explain something to you. That's why our people.
That's my problem now. I've been listening to you too long, man.
That's why our people right now can't get to the top because crabs just like you is.
Talking to the dog when he was so disappointed in what happened and so hurt, he said that's what always keeps our people from getting to the top is that we don't stay together. And I think the blow to his whole inner soul is a tremendous traumatic effect. But I also know the dog, he's a champion and he won't lay down for anybody. Butch Reed, you've made your bed, now you're gonna have to lie in it. Now let's see what everybody thinks of the Junkyard Dog. Is Channel 39 in Houston and Ed Worthington put together a piece about the Atomic Dog, the man we know and love.
Baton Rouge, Louisiana, a legend in professional wrestling. 285 pounds of frustration and toothache. A man who reigns supreme in the square circle. He calls his junkyard the Junkyard Dog. A professional wrestler who has become the kingpin in the Mid-South wrestling. His theme, the Atomic Dog, provides a fitting tribute to this legend.
Yeah, this is a story of famous dog. But the dog that chases its tail will be busy. These are clapping dogs, rhythmic dogs, harmonic dogs, house dogs, street dogs, dogs of the world unite, dancing dogs. Yeah, clapping dogs, funky dogs. Nasty dogs.
Atomic dog. Atomic dog. I Ain't your average.
Thank you to the inimitable Junkyard Dog from Houston, Texas, who is still the North American Heavyweight Champion, and in our hearts and in your eyes as you watch him from week to week, he's truly the Junkyard Dog, the man of the people. And Hacksaw Butch Reed, I chime in along with Cowboy Bill Watts. You've got a long, hard road ahead of you if you think the Junkyard Dog really turned on you on purpose. He didn't turn on you. You'll find it out later on as things unfurl. But I know the Junkyard Dog, and I have faith in him, and the fans have faith. We'll be back with Hacksaw Butch Reed in action after this message from Mid-South Wrestling.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 252 pounds from Kansas City, Missouri, Hacksaw Butch Reed. And in the blue corner at 222 pounds from Knoxville, Tennessee, Tim Horner.
Introduction of this event, popular Tim Horner in the green against Hacksaw Butch Reed, who has changed his personality and has promised to change his tactics in the ring on his way to move to the top in professional wrestling. Joel Armstrong, the referee, says let's get the action underway, and here's Bill Watts.
Well, Tim Horner's not taking any chances. He's going out and stinging him. Oh, but Reed is powerful. You can't take away anything, Boyd Pierce. He's an athlete. He's a great athlete. He's a hungry animal. He's in fantastic shape. His mind may be a little screwed up, as he said that the Junkyard Dog treated him just like he did at Mr. Olympia. And he discarded him for somebody else, for Hacksaw Dugan. But you'll recall, the people elected Hacksaw Dugan as Junkyard Dog's tag partner. The Junkyard Dog had nothing to do with that. And you hear the people chanting JYD now as they want their man of the hour, Junkyard Dog, to come out here and right the wrong. But right now, Tim Horner's in there making a gallant effort, but Hacksaw Butch Reed is a powerful man. He was an All-American linebacker, NEO, Northeastern Oklahoma A&M in Miami, then at Central Missouri State, then for the Kansas City Chiefs. He's a fantastic athlete. And I'll tell you, Junkyard Dog may see right there one of the toughest tests ever. As this man has said right in front of everybody, I'm coming after the North American title. And of course, the North American title means one thing, means dollars. And I think that's where it all gets down to, is that greed for dollars. And Tim Horner really stung him. He really stung Hacksaw Butch Reed. Oh!
Oh, he's coming full force, Bill.
Horner was going for broke. That's the only way he can do it. He knows he's got to go for the big move on the guy that's awesome. And he went, but Butch Reed, like I say, he was a linebacker in pro ball. So he's got that quickness and that agility also. And Reed moved out of the way, and Tim Horner almost took his head off. Wow, he really elevated him there. Reed, very deliberate. You wonder just how much Ted DiBiase had to do with all this, Boyd Pierce.
It seems like everything's something out of the ordinary happens, Bill, somewhere in the small print, the bottom line in the corner of the ring or in the dressing room or down the step. Ted DiBiase has something to do with it.
Butch Reed using those forearms that he has done so well. You know, he was a powerlifter at Central Missouri State also, so he's been a tremendous athlete in many fields for a long time, and I guess he feels that he has to do something drastic in order to make his mark in this world. But I think that that's a cheap way of doing it at the advantage of your best friend. a guy that took you up and down the road, loaned you money when you were hurt and out of the business, and got you your start in Mid-South through Grizzly Smith. And there Hacksaw Butch Reed power presses. Tim Horner just slings him down like yesterday's laundry. And now he seems to want to punish him instead of beat him. He, without a doubt, he had the man beat. There he goes with that. Oh, he turned Tim Horner clear upside down. Tim Horner's beat. Boyd Pierce, he's been beat since the power slam.
Bill, he said he was going to change his tactics and go all the way to the top. I was hoping he was wrong, but undoubtedly he has really doubled his efforts.
I think too many people see the wrong things in life as the way of getting ahead, and they think the cheap shot, the fast way, the sorry way is the way of getting ahead. But I'll tell you, when you run that race of endurance for a long-lasting life, that's not the way. There has to be things of value. There has to be morals. There has to be faith. And Hacksaw Butch Reed has lost his. He has sold himself out. And he is just punishing Tim Horner. Look at this. He is so powerful. Tim Horner's counted down.
Hacksaw Butch Reed gaining a victory over Tim Horner. Tag team action coming up when we return after this word.
This is a non-title tag team event for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner, representing the Mid-South tag team titles, at 270 pounds from Russia, Boris Zirkov. And his partner at 244 pounds, Mr. Olympia. In the blue corner at 250 pounds from Topeka, Kansas, Art Cruz. And his partner at 238 pounds from Indianapolis, Indiana, George Weingroff.
Tag team action being introduced, Art Cruz and George Weingroff against General Skandar Akbar, who proudly presents the Mid-South Tag Team Champions, Mr. Olympia and Boris Zirkov. Your referee, Johnny Martinez, and the man to tell about us, ladies and gentlemen, the outstanding sports director from KALB and Channel 5 in Alexandria, Louisiana, a man who we always use his fine verbal knowledge and description of the matches when he's in our area, Buddy Nichols. Buddy?
Thank you very much, Boyd. As Reese Bowden pointed out, a non-title match, but an opportunity for young Art Cruz and George Weingroff to get a title bout should they happen to upset this Mid-South Tag Team Championship team. Right now, Weingroff, atomic knee drop, and he has Mr. Olympia down, but only for the count of one, as Weingroff and Cruz work a little teamwork over in their corner. Art Cruz, fine youngster from Topeka, Kansas, in, takes a shot to the chest off the foot of Olympia. Olympia quickly tags out to Boris Zirkov, and he goes to work on Art Cruz. Cruz off, good reverse, a hip lock and takedown. Fine move again by Art Cruz. As we said, the youngster out of Topeka, Kansas, board really over the last few weeks has really blossomed into a fine grappler.
He certainly has, and George Weingroff, his partner who's in the ring now, former amateur great and now coming into the professional ranks, does not have total vision, as we pointed out some 2 weeks ago, but an outstanding potential as a grappler.
I think what we have is a good young tag team combination that will not give it up. They'll be in there right to the last blow. Fine young skilled athletes. Right now, however, they are being handled quite easily by the team of Mr. Olympia and Boris Zirkov, the Mid-South Tag Team Champions. Weingroff into the rope, the big right foot of Zirkov into the chest area, and he measures him now for a blow to the midsection again with the head and the shoulders, and Weingroff makes it over to the corner. Here comes Art Kent. Kent with a couple of right hands to the chin. Again, the flip, and Zirkov hits hard, but he comes up quick, and Art Cruz is there to knock him down again with a flying drop kick. He's working hard on him. Cruz goes for the monkey flip. However, Zirkov holds on to the turnbuckle on the far side, and Cruz goes down hard. Skandar Akbar in the corner giving advice, and right now he is trying to control Mid-South Wrestling.
He has Devastation Incorporated and King Kong Bundy, Ted DiBiase, and right now the tag team champions, Boyd. So he has a lot of talent over in his stable.
Exactly.
Again, Art Cruz, a very skillful flying dropkick. Now one to Olympia. Here comes Weingroff into the ring. We've got a Pierce Sixer. Everybody into the ring. Weingroff dropkicks Olympia again. And Cruz working on Zirkov, but right now Zirkov gets him. Reverse neck breaker, and Cruz has his back to the canvas. Zirkov goes to the second strand of ropes. Weingroff, however, comes in quickly and gets a big right hand to the midsection coming down. Art Cruz, a couple of right hands. There's Mr. Olympia with that loaded boot. He's got something on that right boot. And a flying drop kick to Art Cruz, and Cruz is out like a light. And Zirkov with the pinning combination, 1, 2, 3.
Olympia loading up the boot on the outside as Johnny Martinez was putting George Weingroff out of the ring and did not see it. Nevertheless, a victory for the Mid-South Tag Team Champions, Mr. Olympia and Boris Zirkov. We'll be back when action continues after these words.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit in the red corner at 227 pounds from Los Angeles, California. Rip Rogers. And in the blue corner at 237 pounds from Virginia Beach, Virginia, Magnum T.A.
Action continues now. The popular star, Magnum T.A., Terry Allen, as Joel Armstrong calls for the bell. Magnum T.A.'s opponent, the colorful Rip Rogers. Here's Buddy Nichols to tell us about it.
You know, Boyd, one of the nice things about dealing with sports and athletes is the opportunity to meet young men like Terry Allen, Magnum T.A. I met him just before the matches today, and he is really a very personable young man, one with a lot of wrestling talent, and as we mentioned last week, one with a lot of desire and an opportunity to go a long way in this wrestling business. Right now, Rip Rogers has him with a forearm off the ropes. Magnum T.A. in a little bit of problems. Rip Rogers using the hair, but a nice reversal by Magnum. And again, the hip toss, and Rip Rogers goes down hard. Again, the backflip off the ropes, and Rogers in his colorful lavender tights goes down hard, but he moves out of the way just in time as Magnum tries for the elbow drop. Again, the action hot and heavy here. Again, nice move by Magnum. A strong elbow to the midsection, catching Rogers coming off, and then another one to the chin, and that put Rip Rogers down hard. Takes him high into the air. And the atomic knee drop, and Rogers in a lot of pain as that had to hurt. He pulls up, gets the leverage, and 1, 2, 3, Magnum.
2, 3, Magnum T.A., Terry Allen gains the measure of Rip Rogers here on Mid-South Wrestling. And stay with us, we'll be back right after this important message. Wrestling fans, many of you have been asking about the Herald Mil Máscaras. Now, Mil Máscaras will be with us here on Mid-South Wrestling next week. And all of you know, Mil Máscaras, as I know, is probably the most Herald International known Mexican star in professional wrestling today. Also, to millions in his native Mexico, his country, he's a cinema idol, as he has been for many years. And we're looking forward to him being here on Mid-South Wrestling next week. However, right now, we're going to show you an important match. Mil Máscaras versus the Black Ninja, Kendo Nagasaki, that was held in Houston, Texas, at the Sam Houston Coliseum on May the 13th, narrated by the man who, for 35 years, behind the mic, in Houston, Texas, wrestling Mr. Paul Bosch. Let's watch it right now.
And Mil Máscaras holds it. He strengthens his legs by hanging on to the head of the Black Ninja. The ninja is wondering what hit him. He doesn't usually come up against people who fathom his style quite as readily as Mil Máscaras has. Stepped on his nose that time. The nose protruding that mask, and here is Ninja. No, there's a switch. Ninja hits and hits hard. Máscaras delivers a beautiful drop kick. He's adroit with his feet. And Mil Máscaras is in tremendous condition here tonight, as he always is. I want to remind you that our ticket office at 1919 Caroline, that's at the corner of Pierce in downtown Houston, will be open Sunday this week. Sunday 9 to 4, then Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday 9 to 4, and Friday 9 to 5. And Friday is the night of our matches. The tickets move over to the Coliseum. We've got lots of seats. This is a big building. So if you are unable to get your tickets in advance, then be sure that you come to the Coliseum on Friday night. He really unbuckled that time, and as he comes out, he tries to cut the head off of the Black Ninja. He's going for a back body slam, and he got it. And here is Mil Máscaras looking to hit the Ninja. Beautiful drive and layout. A tremendous ovation, and the Black Ninja is down on the mat wondering what hit him and wondering what has happened to him. Listen to those people. Get a camera on the crowd. Oh, that crowd. Everybody standing up, everybody screaming, everybody roaring in favor of Mil Máscaras, and we have a massive crowd at the Coliseum tonight. Wrestling has never been in better shape. Never have there been more fans, more enthusiastic fans for Houston wrestling than there are right now.
We viewed the man was talking about, the high-flying Mil Máscaras in action in a match in Houston, Texas versus the Black Ninja Kendo Nagasaki. And Mil will be with us here next week on Mid-South Wrestling in person. We also hope, in answer to a lot of your requests, that Chavo Guerrero will be back in the very near future. Our pleasure this week, as always, when he's in the area, to have our splendid guest commentator for a portion of the matches, the Herald Sports Director of Channel 5, KALB, in Alexandria, Louisiana, Buddy Nichols. Buddy, another job well done. I know you might have a few closing comments before you leave us.
Boyd, first of all, thank you very much. Again, a very hospitable time. The last couple of weeks, I thank you very much for your patience and working with you. A lot of things happening in the Mid-South wrestling circuit, as always, and like you say, you never know what's going to happen from one match to the next. And, of course, the biggest surprise, of course, I guess, is Butch Reed.
Well, in summing it up and using a big word that I hardly ever use, as I sat here 2 weeks ago, or last week it was, and seen the change in Butch Reed as he vowed to go to the top by using the tactics, whatever he had to have, I was utterly flabbergasted and had to go off the air for a commercial break. I never seen something like that. It really bothers me to see a good man go wrong, and I hope he's proved wrong by the Junkyard Dog somewhere down the line, because the dog has been falsely charged. Till next week, Boyd Pearson. Goodbye, everybody, from Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.